Hello everyone, this video is about Chapter 1, Introduction to Statistics. What is statistics? Statistics is the science of data. This involves collecting, classifying, summarizing, organizing, analyzing, presenting, and interpreting numerical information. Statistical methods are particularly useful for studying, analyzing, and learning about populations. What is a population? A population is a set of units, usually people, objects, transactions, or events that we are interested in studying. An experimental unit is an object, like person, thing, transaction, or event, about which we collect data. In studying a population, we focus on one or more characteristics or properties of the unit in the population. We call such characteristics variables. For example, we may be interested in the variables age, gender, and number of years of education. Typically, the population of interest in most applications are large, involving perhaps many thousands. A reasonable alternative would be to select and study a subset or portion of the unit in the population, which we call a sample. When you select a sample, you need to make sure that the sample is a random sample, which means every value in the population has an equal chance of being selected. Usually, the application of statistics can be divided into two broad areas: descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. For descriptive statistics, we use numerical and graphical methods of the data, like Chapter 2. For inferential statistics, we use sample data to make estimates, decisions, predictions, or other generalizations about the population, like Chapter 7. Now, I'll introduce different types of data. All data can be classified as one of the two general types: qualitative data, which means categories, no numbers, and quantitative data, which means numerical. The qualitative data can also be classified into ordinal and nominal. What's the difference between them? For ordinal data, there is a meaningful ordering. For example, class, standing, ranking, categories. For nominal data, there is no meaningful ordering. One category is not better than another. For example, gender, or the state in the US, and color. The quantitative data can also be classified into continuous and discrete. What is the difference between them? For continuous data, it can be infinite number of values. For example, time, weight, and volume, which means you can have decimals as many as you want. For discrete data, it can be countable numbers, which means you can't have decimals, integers only. For example, number of students and number of cars. For quantitative data, there is another method to classify: ratio and interval. What's the difference between them? For ratio data, ratios of the values are meaningful. Zero means none. For example, length, weight, distance, and salary. For interval data, ratios of the values are not meaningful. No inherent definition of zero value. Here is a special example. Temperature in F or in C, 0 degrees does not mean no heat. Once you decide on the type of data, qualitative or quantitative, you need to collect the data. Generally, you can obtain data in three different ways. First, from a published source, such as a book, journal, newspaper, or website. A second method of collecting data involves conducting a designed experiment, like medical study. Finally, observational studies can be used to collect data. The most common type of observational study is a survey, where the researcher samples a group of people, ask one or more questions, and recording the responses. That's all for Chapter 1.